Okay, we have the next question that says, consider the species zinc 70 with atomic mass of 72, arsenic with atomic mass of 75, and germanium with atomic mass of 74. These species have the same number of electrons. Of course, that is not true because they have different number of protons and they are not isoelectric species. Hence, they can't have equal number of electrons. B says same number of proton. You can see that the atomic number is the number of proton, right? Are they having the same atomic number? No. This has an atomic number of 30. This has 33, and this has what? 34. The next option says same number of neutron. Is that true? Let's see. Then D, the same mass number. Of course, that is wrong. They don't have the same mass number. They have different what? Mass number. These have a mass number of 72, this 75, and this what? 74. So let's see for the same number of neutron. The number of neutron is P plus N is equal to atomic mass. That is to say that the number of proton plus neutron is equal to the atomic mass. The number of proton here is 30 plus that of the neutron, atomic mass is 72. Neutron will be what? 72 minus 30, which is equals to 72 minus 30 is what? Is 42. So we have the number of neutron for this is equals to 42. Let's look at this one. Same thing, proton plus neutron, what is equals to the atomic mass. Where's the proton there? 33. Neutron is unknown. Atomic mass is 75. Neutron equals to 75 minus 33, and that is equals to 42. Same is applicable here. This automatically, you know it to be what? 74 minus this is germanium, atomic number of germanium, atomic number is 32, minus 32, and this gives us 42. So you see that all of them has the atomic, the number of neutron is equals to 42. So the correct answer is option C, same number of neutron. Now the next question says, which of the following elements and valence electron is incorrect? Which of the following elements and valence electron is incorrect? Now, you have your options. Aluminium, 3. Then you have bromine, 7. Then you have bromine, 7. Sulfur, 4. And then strontium, 2. Strontium 2, sulfur 4. Now you agree with me that aluminium is a group 3 element, so it must have 3 valence electrons. Bromine is in group 7, so it must have 7 valence electrons. Sulfur is a group 6 element. Are you getting me now? Sulfur is group 6 and hence cannot have 4 valence electrons. It's supposed to have 6 valence electrons. So this one is the wrong one here. Strontium is group 2 and hence it has 2 valence electrons. So your correct answer is sulfur 4 is wrong, is incorrect. Next question says, with regards to the species, which of the following statement is correct with regard to this species? Now, A, all these species contain 10 electrons. Is that true? Yeah. Now, this species, they are called, these two are isoelectric to neon. Are we getting it? Now, isoelectric species, they are ions of different atoms that have the same number of what? Electrons. Ions of different atoms that have the same number of electrons. Are we getting it? Either by gaining or by losing electrons. For instance, if you look at oxygen, oxygen has 8 electrons normally because it has number of proton, 8, atomic number 8. Now, 2 minus spins, oxygen has gained additional 2 electrons, making this one to be what? 10 electrons. Fluorine, same thing. It has 9 electrons normally because it has atomic number of 9. Plus, this minus here means it has gained 1 electron, and this gives us 10 electrons. Neon, normally, it has 10 electrons because atomic number for neon is 10. So you see that the 3 species have what? The same number of electron, which is 10 electron. Now, species like this are called isoelectric species. I can say they are isoelectronic. Which of the following does not have a noble gas electronic configuration, or which of the following is not isoelectric with a noble gas? You have X2 minus, Ba positive, aluminium 3 plus, and antimony 3 minus. Now, their group number will tell you the one that has a noble gas configuration and the one that would likely not have a noble gas configuration. Now, sulfur is group 6 plus 2 electron. It has what? How many electrons in its atomic share? 8 electrons. Hence, this one has what? A noble gas configuration. Now, barium is group 2 plus, now this one electron here means barium has given out how many electrons? 1 electron, which is 2 minus 1, and this gives us 1 electron. Is that so? Now, aluminium is group 3. Now, 3 plus means aluminium has given out 3 electrons. Now, since it has given out 3 electrons, aluminium will not have any electron in its outermost shell. And because it's not having electron in its atomic shell, we have the electronic configuration of a noble gas, because the electronic configuration for aluminium is 3, 8, 2, 8, 3. So if it gives out this 3 electron, which is the 3 plus, it becomes 2 and 8. And 8 is the electronic configuration for 2 and 8 is the electronic configuration for neon. Are we getting it now? So it is isoelectric with a noble gas. Now let's look at antimony. Antimony is group 5. 3 minus means it has gained how many electrons? 3 electrons. Are we getting it? 3 minus means it gained. When it's negatively charged, it means it what? Gains. And this gives us what? 8. So you see that each of them, 8 electrons in their outermost share, apart from barium. Now, had it been barium, was given as barium 2 plus. Now, it will now be what? 2 minus 2, which is equals to 0. Are you getting it? When you do this mathematics, if it gives you 0, it means it has now fallen back to a noble gas configuration. But if it gives you anything less than 8 and 0, it means that it's not a noble gas and it's not isoelectric with a noble gas. So that is that for that question. So the correct answer is B, which is classified as a non-polar covalent bond. Which is classified as a non-polar covalent bond. Now you have HI bond in HI. Let's just be bringing out the bonds. We have HS bond in H2S, PCl bond in dash, an NCl bond. Now, when you say something is non-polar, it means that the electronegativity differences between the two atoms are what? Close. Are we getting it? The electronegativity differences between the two atoms forming the bonds are close. Hence, such bonds are said to be what? Non-polar. Now, if you look at the first one, this is a group 7 element, and this group, let's assume hydrogen is acting as group 1 element here. Now, you see that the electronegativity difference between these two elements is very wide, and hence this element is polar. Are we getting it now? Hydrogen and sulfur. Sulfur is group 6, hydrogen is group 1. Electronegativity difference very, very wide, large. Now, let's look at phosphorus and chlorine. Phosphorus is in group 5, chlorine is in group 7. Same applicable here, nitrogen is in group 5. Chlorine is in group 7. So the bone of contention now is between these two atoms. Now let's see the one that will likely win the race. If you look at the periodic table, you have nitrogen, then you have phosphorus under. Are we getting it? Now, electronegativity does what? Does it increase from top to bottom or it decreases? Electronegativity decreases from top to bottom. Are we getting it now? If electronegativity decreases from top to bottom, it means that nitrogen is more electronegative. Are you getting it? Than phosphorus. Are you getting it? Less electronegative. Since nitrogen is more electronegative than phosphorus, it means that nitrogen is closer in electronegativity to chlorine than phosphorus. Are we getting it now? It means that what? Nitrogen is closer in electronegativity to chlorine than phosphorus, because nitrogen is more electronegative than what? Phosphorus. And chlorine is more electronegative than both. Are we getting it? It's more like this is more powerful. Which of them is more closer to the powerful one? That one we what? We drag with it. It will be the bone of contention. And when we predicted it, we saw that nitrogen is more what? Electronegative than phosphorus when you count down the group. So the correct answer is this. This is a non-polar bond. This is non-polar. Are we getting it now? Which of the following compound is likely to be ionic? This is germanium arsenide or arsenide, whichever way you want to call that compound. This is scandium chloride. And this is NO2. And this is CCl4. Which of them is likely to be ionic? Are we getting it now? Now, if you look at this, germanium is very close to arsenic. Are you getting it? I mean, gallium is very close to arsenic. Gallium is 31, I believe. Arsenic is 33. You see that the differences between these two are not that much. Now, if you look at scandium and chlorine, scandium is likely to be classified as group 1. In the transition series, group 1A. Are we getting it now? Because it's the first element in the transition series, and therefore it will have one valence electron. Chlorine is group 7. Are we getting it? So the differences between these two is very, very what? Large. The differences between these two is very, very large. And since the differences between these two is very, very large, this one is likely to be ionic. Because we said ionic bond is the bond that is formed between two compounds with large electronegativity differences. The last one is NO. Nitrogen and oxygen are very close in electronegativity. Carbon and chlorine, same thing. So the one that is likely to be ionic is SCl3, ionic compound. And then we have a question on isotopy. The question says, which of the following is true about the isotopes of elements? The correct answer is that isotopes have the same number of electrons. Are we getting it now? Because we are told that the isotopes of elements are those atoms that have the same number of protons but different number of neutrons, which further leads to different atomic mass. So if they have the same number of protons, and we say that the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons, it means that the isotopes of elements have the same number of electrons. For instance, tritium and deuterium and protium, they are all isotopes of one element, but they all have what? One proton and one electron. So that is basically all for this past question. Now, in our next class, we are going to discuss other questions on chemistry. Thank you for your time and God bless. Ta-ta!